shelves at smoke shops across Massachusetts are bare a day after the governor announced a temporary ban on all vaping products. The governor made that move declaring a public health emergency.
But stores that rely on e-cigarette sales worry that this could destroy their business and send customers over the border. WBZ's Beth Germano has the story tonight.
The vaping inventory is coming off the shelves at Two Brothers Smoke and Vape Shop in Lowell. The four-month ban has hit the seven-month-old business hard, where vaping products are nearly 90% of what they sell.
It was just out of nowhere, you know, boom. We didn't expect it.
Boxes are being loaded for now, hoping the products will still be sellable when the ban is over. Manager Nelson Ferrer says isolating Massachusetts business owners won't keep people in the state from buying vaping products.
Nashua, New Hampshire is 10 minutes away from here. And it's like, if they're going to cross over, they're going to get it no matter what. So it doesn't make sense having the ban here and not everywhere else.
In fact, Salem, New Hampshire is about 20 miles away, where Zach Medeiros of Massachusetts was at Smoker Choice doing exactly that.
Forces me to come up here to get the products. I think prohibition doesn't do anything. It's just going to force a lot of people to do that.
Store owner Ali Sheikh expects about a 30% bump in business, even as he worries New Hampshire could consider its own ban.
Anytime something happens in Massachusetts, people in New Hampshire do get worried if it's going to go federal or not. But so far, we haven't heard anything like that.
Stores like Smoker's Choice in New Hampshire say they've already been contacted by Massachusetts distributors about buying some of their product, and they expect to hear from individual vape stores as well. That could be an option at Two Brothers in Lowell as they are determined to survive.
We're going to ride the wave. We can survive, but it's just, you know, it's really a hard hit right now.
And even harder with competition so close by. In Lowell, Beth Germano, WBZ News.